Earlier this month, California was rocked by a powerful earthquake that measured magnitude 7.1, the biggest quake to hit the state in 20 years. It has subsequently experienced further quakes and shocks in the aftermath. Why the high level of activity recently, and what's the history of earthquake activity in this region? I sat down with Steven Dunn, a professor of geology at Mount Holyoke College, to get some answers.
The earthquake activity that they're having is fairly normal in a long time span of what's typical. The Ridgecrest earthquakes are notable in a few regards. They're a little active fault zone near the Mojave. And on July 4th, actually, the first one occurred, which was, I think, a 6.4 magnitude. And everyone would have assumed that there would be many aftershocks because there's always large numbers of aftershocks after a sizable quake. And then the next day on July 5th, there was a 7.1, which is a much larger earthquake, which was not normally expected. So then we look back at the July 4th earthquake and call that a foreshock or a precursor to a larger one. And that's not normal. Typically, when you have a sizable earthquake, it's not preceded by particular recognizable activity, but in this case, it was. I shouldn't make it sound like that's terribly rare, but it is certainly not the normal way. And then since the 7.1, there's been literally thousands of following earthquakes, all of small magnitude, magnitude four and less, and that's very typical. That's the way earthquakes go.
So thousands, that's normal to have that kind of activity.
It is. And the larger the earthquake, the main event, the larger it is, the more you can expect significant numbers of aftershocks, and the larger the aftershocks will be. So in a really large earthquake, you can expect that there will be more, and some of them will be sizable. Potentially damaging. And so whenever you have an earthquake, especially a large one, authorities will warn people to stay away from structures that look unsafe. Follow-up earthquakes can be significant. But it's not typical that you would see a following earthquake that's larger than what than a large earthquake that happened previously.
When you look at this historically, so it's 7.1 was the greater one on July 5th, largest one I think since the early 1990s. Mm-hmm. And historically, if you can kind of bring us up to date on just kind of what we would expect looking back through history at the size of these earthquakes.
Well, anything in the range of 7 or higher is a noteworthy earthquake. Once you're below around 5, you would not expect there to be significant damage. And so of the large earthquakes, magnitude 7 and larger, on a global scale, you could figure that there will be about 2 per year someplace on the planet, that there would be 2 really large ones, maybe more like approaching an 8, say, magnitude on the Richter scale. So in California alone, you might expect there to be one a century, maybe a couple a century. Of 7.0s, maybe there would be at least a couple every 100 years, maybe a few. It's like the law of averages. You don't know when or how many. You could have a cluster of 5 or 6 in a few decades. That's not very likely, but it could happen. Or you could actually go a whole century without having a significant sizable seismic event. But the one that happened in Ridgecrest I don't want to say it's of no concern. Any big earthquake is of concern. But the ones along the San Andreas, in particular in the regions of large populations, Los Angeles and the entire Bay Area, that's where most of the concern would be in California.
And when you look at the East Coast, you know, this is not something that we're typically used to, not a lot of headlines about it, but it has happened here. Tell us a little bit about, I believe we were talking before about the one in 2011.
Right. There was a pretty good earthquake in Virginia. My memory is saying 5.8. It was a pretty good size earthquake, and it damaged the Washington Monument, which had to be closed for a couple years for repairs. It was felt throughout New York City and Boston. People scrambled out of buildings because tall buildings were shaking. And that did quite a bit of damage, and that's not even that large of an earthquake. But when you have large population centers, and particularly here in the Northeast and anywhere in the East, the continental crust is not as broken up and shattered by faulting as California is. And so when an earthquake happens here, the energy is transmitted much farther and is felt with a harder sort of jolt. And so that earthquake in Virginia was felt all along the eastern seaboard entirely.
And when you think of that, all the way up to Boston, and I remember Western Mass as well, there were some reports about that.
It's also interesting here in Massachusetts, there was a really large earthquake off of Cape Ann back in the 1700s, 250 years ago. And that one was felt, it did damage all the way to New Haven, which is an example of how when a large earthquake happens in the Northeast, you can feel it, the shaking, for a much longer distance. And we also have events in what's called the New Madrid Fault of southeastern Missouri that had 4 7.5 magnitude. We have to estimate because they're historic and we didn't have the Richter scale, but in 1811 and 1812, over a two-year period, there were 4 magnitude 7.5s in this obscure location in southeast Missouri, which now is close to Memphis, Tennessee, and several other cities. So if you look at a hazard map that the U.S. Geological Survey maintains of where earthquake danger exists in the U.S., you see a large area of concern centered around that part of the U.S. over here on the East Coast. And the East Coast near Charlotte, there was Charleston, South Carolina, there was a major earthquake in the 1880s. You had the Cape Ann earthquake here off the coast of Massachusetts. You have these New Madrid earthquakes in Missouri. So we are not far removed from potential earthquake damage and a hazard. However, the chances of one happening in any given year are incredibly low, whereas in places in California, the chances are much, much higher. So could an earthquake happen here, causing significant damage, loss of life, et cetera? Yes. In fact, it's likely that it will. But when and where, we have no idea. And the likelihood in any given, even decade, is very, very small.